everybody, and welcome to a very special edition of Reality of Wrestling. Welcome to the 300th Reality of Wrestling event here on the Reality of Wrestling YouTube channel. We want to thank everybody for joining. We want to thank everybody for subscribing. We want to thank everybody for tuning in to what is shaping up to be the absolute biggest main event of 2021 so far for the Reality of Wrestling. In our main event this evening, one of the most prestigious titles that we have in this company's history, the Diamonds Division Championship, whose lineage now dates back nearly 7 years, will be decided tonight as the brand new champion, Promise Braxton, goes one-on-one with the returning AQA. Now, this match is no normal match. It is not under normal circumstances. We have found out that this will be AQA's final appearance, in-ring appearance, for the Reality of Wrestling. This is her last contracted match, and she will try to do what only few have ever done, leave the company with a championship around her waist. But let's waste no further time. Let's get into the action this week on the 300th edition of the Reality of Wrestling. And here we go. One half of the Reality of Wrestling Tag Team Champions. It's Shawn Hendrix. You hear this, or you see the shirt rather, right there. I am Legion Scum, but oddly enough, the leader of the longest running demonic collective has become somewhat of a, dare I say, fan favorite in recent weeks. Out here flying solo, has got a big match in front of him.
His opponent, the opponent to the ring, by Kent Hall, representing the Renegades of Wrestling. Next, he is Warren.
What some call the leader of the Renegades of Wrestling, Warren Johnson. Warren Johnson, absolutely incredible competitor. There's no doubt about what he can do inside the squared circle. But again, this is a man who is winking at himself in the mirror when he wakes up in the morning. And you have to think that could be to his downfall at times. Egotistical, the word that comes to mind when describing Warren Johnson. But personalities might clash, but do they really matter when you get inside the confines of the squared circle? The only thing that matters at the end of the day is the 1, 2, and 3, and your hand being raised, trash being spoken and talked between these two competitors. We're about to get it on. This is a former tag team champion in Warren Johnson taking on one half of the current tag team champions in Legion. And here we go. These two circling one another. Interesting to see guys who are tag team specialists getting it done in a singles capacity. We've seen them both do that in years past. And Shawn Hendrix was wearing a weight belt when he walked into the World Gym Arena, and it is obviously not for show. He is able to go muscle for muscle, ounce of strength versus ounce of strength with Warren Johnson as these two circle one another again. Collar and elbow tie up. One trying to get the advantage of the other. You see this sometimes when the strength just cancels each other out. You have to find a different means, median, or mode to get in there. Warren Johnson cracking a smile on the face. He knows in the back of his mind he's got Dex in his corner, always there to even the odds. Another collar and elbow tie up. Now Warren Johnson has him up against the top rope. Referee to a count of three, breaks the count, going for a chop, and then he finds one in return from Shawn Hendrix. Overhand chop to the chest. Warren Johnson retreating to the corner. Irish whip. Warren Johnson looking to go up and over. Shawn Hendrix had it scouted. Back suplex to perfection. Is he going to go for a cover? He does cover here. One. And a kick out after one. Going to have to do more than that. Shawn Hendrix even looking at the referee saying, man, that was only one? Yes, it was only a one count as we have our special socially distanced crowd. Everyone donning a mask to remain safe here in the World Gym Arena. But the one man who is not safe right now has to be Shawn Hendrix, because he is having to not battle only Warren Johnson. There is Dex there, and off of the distraction, Warren Johnson getting the upper hand, putting the boots and the forearms to Shawn Hendrix. Isaiah James not joining Shawn Hendrix here at ringside. They have been very impressive as tag team champions. This starts us off tonight at our, there's a two count. This starts us off tonight at our 300th episode of The Reality of Wrestling. Here's a little trivia fact. Let's see if anyone in the comments can pick it up. Who is the only person to be featured on all 300 episodes of The Reality of Wrestling? See if you can get that trivia question right in the comments below, as Shawn Hendrix continues now to put on the offense to Warren Johnson. Dex getting up there. Zach Mason, of course, a former tag team partner of Warren Johnson. That's why he was on my mind. Great trip there, and a kick to the back of the head. Got him by the waist. Oh, a bat suplex of his own in retaliation to the one from earlier. Kick one, two, and a kick out after two. Shawn Hendrix, earlier when he did the back suplex, Warren Johnson kicked out a one. Warren Johnson got a two out of that one. Still not enough for either man to get the victory. The all-important three count. Neither of them known as submission specialists, but you never know what they've been working on during this time. Warren Johnson has a very strong grip around the neck and head of one half of the Reality of Wrestling Tag Team Champions as we are sitting here at the moment. Snapmare. And look at that, almost corkscrewing the neck. And you can tell Shawn Hendrix just felt that one. I have never seen that before. Proud of his work as Warren Johnson. I think he's gonna go for it. Oh, a double scoop right there. One, two, man. Jaw-jacking with the referee won't make him alter his decision. Nevertheless, you have to think some of the vertebrae in the spinal column and the neck might be altered in Shawn Hendrix's body as we're speaking, and Warren Johnson sensing blood in the water and staying on him. And look at that. Distracting the referee momentarily. Dex getting involved. With an MJ shrug, Dex continues about his business. And Warren... Oh! Elbow to the side of the dome piece. More tune for your head top. Cover. One. As Shawn Hendrix said, not that easy. Another cover one. And another kick out. Hooking the leg this time, getting a two. No dice, though. Shawn Hendrix said, not that easy. When it comes to inside the squared circle, I've been grinding all my life. Rest in peace to the legend Nipsey Hussle. As this match continues and the World Gym Arena getting behind Shawn Hendrix, the leader of Legion. A man who, in years past, tormented many members of the Reality Wrestling roster and the crowd alike. Now he's finding himself as the good guy of this story. Well, the Book of Legion continues to grow. The Julian year comes and goes and passes again. Cover here. Reversal. Warren had it scouted. Oh, beautiful right there. It goes for it again. That neck crank. Warren Johnson. Wow. Innovative offense is the only terms that can come to my mind to describe what we are seeing with Warren Johnson right now when it comes to that neck crank that he does with his lower extremities. Oh! Had it scouted. A big moment there for Shawn Hendrix. This might be what he needs to find his way back in it. AC, he's headbanging. The neck must be all right or the adrenaline is set in. Big lariat. Following up with another. The boot stopping the offense. Shawn Hendrix ducks anyway, and a big boot of his own. Can he do it, brother? One, two, and a kick out. Hendrix Mania was running wild momentarily with a big boot and a leg drop. Don't tell me he's been saying his prayers and eating his vitamins as he goes off to the apron and now looking for some high risk as he ascends to the top rope, perched in that precarious position. Beautiful.
Ooh, you. Dig it.
Shades of the Macho Man Randy Savage. You are not watching Saturday night's main event. You are seeing the 300th episode of Reality Wrestling Cover 2 and oh, look at that. Dex. Dex putting the foot on the bottom rope. Disgusting move right there. Rolls of the eyes from the audience. And now Shawn Hendrix taking his eye off the ball. Not a smart maneuver when you have Warren Johnson there. Well, that'll put a stop to anybody's championship run. Springboard DDT cover. One, two, three. Warren Johnson has beaten one half of the Reality Wrestling Tag Team Champions. You have to think the Renegades of Wrestling are well in line for an opportunity at those Raw Tag Team titles. Warren Johnson may be the first or one of few if he would be able to win those titles back to win the championships with two different teams here at the Reality of Wrestling. And if he looks like he did tonight, sans the interference from Big Dex, he can get that job done. Incredible performance, incredible action, incredible match with Warren Johnson. And now we will take it to Will All Day, right now.
Fans, I am standing backstage with the reigning Texas champion, Will All Day. Will, congratulations. Last time we saw you compete, Christmas Chaos. Another victory for you, this time against Brenden Steen. But I brought you here because there's been some rumors, there's been some rumbles going on about the state of your condition to compete. Would you be able to clear the air for us here and for the Row Nation?
Yeah, Chris, I'm just going to get down to it. You know, I'm not medically cleared to compete tonight. And, you know, everybody knows that when you get in the ring with Brenden Steen, you go to war. And so even though that was on the fly, I was ready for that war. But, you know, what everybody doesn't know is that I went into that match hurt. And, you know, I don't know if it's pride or ego getting in my way or if it's just the fact that I was so amped up to get in the ring with Rex Andrews that I was just blinded. Now, when I get to the arena, I'm so excited and I'm so ready and I'm so pumped, even though I'm walking into this with a bum back. And I get a call from Booker T, and he lets me know that Rex Andrews left something at home and he wasn't going to be able to make it tonight. And then I figured it out. Rex, you left your nuts at home. You know, that's why you can't make it. You know, I know you got a good life now. I know you got a dog and you got a girl. And, you know, maybe you just lost a desire, but I'm pretty sure you just lost your nuts. Now, I'm here. I'm not medically compared to compete tonight, but I'm here. That's what a champion does, Rex. Now, whenever you're ready, the Texas champion's going to be waiting for you.
Familia!
Well, here comes one half of La Familia and a medical update regarding Will Alday, the Texas champion. He was injured in that street fight with Brenden Steen. You just heard it, but he still wants to go one-on-one with the inaugural Texas champion, Rex Andrews. We're wishing a speedy recovery to our friend, William Alday. But right now, we turn our attention to Johnathan Vega being flanked by Diego de la Cruz. Still auditioning for the Kenosha Kickers. Nevertheless, that reference never gets old, and neither does the sweet sound of Diego de la Cruz on the accordion. Classy, as always, the man who is bringing the mullet back, the man who took Will Alday to the limit. We were just talking about him in that very same match that Will got hurt in. He was across the ring from this man, a former television champion, a two-time Pro Award winner, the professional, Brenden Steen. Jaw-jacking here between the professional and Johnathan Vega. Johnathan Vega and Diego de la Cruz, most recently former Reality Wrestling Tag Team Champions. All the tag teams seem to be going it alone tonight, showcasing their abilities, their single star potential on this Reality of Wrestling's 300th edition. We still have a major, massive main event coming up next. AQA returns to take on Promise Braxton for the Reality Wrestling Diamonds Division Championship, and I will have a special guest joining me on commentary. The two-time Hall of Famer himself, Booker T, will be on commentary for our main event as Diego de la Cruz being sent to the back. Johnathan Vega, interesting, telling Diego he'll be okay. And now a true one-on-one contest. Collar and elbow tie up. Steen sending Johnathan Vega straight into the corner. No surprise there. Brenden Steen, the stronger, the bigger of the two. Will size and strength be able to overcome speed and agility? It is a tale as old as time. That is why styles will always make fights. Oh! I'll tell you what. Johnathan Vega might be the smaller of the two competitors inside the ring. Great right there. He might be the smaller of the two competitors inside the ring, but there's no denying the size of this man's heart. Johnathan Vega is a true competitor. He is a true fighter. He is a true warrior. And right there, look at that. Beautiful cover. One, two. Innovative offense. Key word of the night. Another cover there and a near fall. Brenden Steen, though, real old school. Kick to the gut, that'll stop a man in his tracks. And now look at that. Look at that suplex, just holding him up there like it's nothing. Johnathan Vega, though, inside cradle. Cover one, two, and a, wow. If the referee might have been in a slightly better position there quicker, Johnathan Vega could have had that victory. Got away with an overhand right there after a couple, in between a couple of chops. Brenden Steen really just throwing his entire body weight behind those chops. Choking now, strangling Johnathan Vega. Huracarana! Huracarana right there from Johnathan Vega. Head full of steam, up and over. Oh, and a kick to the back of Steen. Oh my goodness, off the top rope with a leg drop to the back of the neck, cover two and a kick out. Vega displeased from that near fall, but we've seen Brenden Steen go through hell in a handbasket and back again and still live to fight another day.
Beautiful, though, again, by Johnathan Vega outsmarting the professional, which typically doesn't happen. The thing about Brenden Steen is he is a five-tool player. He can fight with you. He can wrestle with you. But he is disoriented by the coming from all angles offense of Vega. Oh, and just catching him there. Oh, and the spine right in the middle of the back, getting acquainted with the ring apron. That is the steel section of this ring. Obviously not meant to comfort the column. It lies in the back. Oh, and look at that. Beautiful. Lariat right there. Cover one, two, and a kick out. Shades of Texas wrestling legend John Bradshaw Layfield, the soon-to-be Hall of Famer known for his clothesline from hell. And I don't know if that was from hell, but it was sure as hell close. Brenden Steen thinking right here. Seems like a guy who Stan Hansen and Bruiser Brody would really love. Oh! Look at that, beautiful. Tilt-a-whirl backbreaker. One, two, kick out. Brenden Steen looking to utilize that Russian leg sweep. And again, going back to the strangling of Johnathan Vega. Chokes not allowed in the reality of wrestling. Brenden Steen thinking he might have got into a bar fight at Stuttgart next door. You see Johnathan Vega still able to use the speed, but he's a little bit slower. The effects of this match weighing down on him. And a buckle bomb. Beautiful reversal into a buckle bomb. We know how dangerous that maneuver can be. Off the second row with an X Factor, cover two and a half. Shades of soon-to-be two-time Hall of Famer Shawn Waltman made the X Factor famous, but not from the second rope. Brenden Steen a style all his own, side headlock here on the mat. And you see, this is his strategy, restricting the airflow to the brain, trying to slow down the pace of Johnathan Vega. That is the way that he will be able to get in there. That is the way that he will find his opening. Be able to finally put away the former Reality Wrestling Tag Team Champion. Oh. Right hand, left chop. Right hand. Left chop. It's not the cha-cha slide when you're in the 20 by 20 by any means. And look at Johnathan Vega. He felt that last shot. He literally dropped to his knees, and he's asking for more from Brenden Steen. That right hand and that left combination might help you a little bit. And that might help you a lot. Looking for another hurricanrana, perhaps. No, he just sent Brenden Steen in the second turnbuckle. Face first. Oh, wait a minute. Torture rack position. Reversal into an arm drag. Hold on here. Oh, tilt-a-whirl head scissor. Sending Brenden Steen, the professional, all the way to the outside. Johnathan Vega tried this earlier. Will it work this time? Up top, down low. Beautiful cross body from the top rope. This is the 300th edition of the flagship of Texas wrestling. This is the reality of wrestling. Johnathan Vega throwing him back inside. Gonna look for that pinfall victory. Wait a minute, no, going back up top. I don't know how smart that is. Take it back, cover, one, two, and a kick out after two. Did Johnathan Vega allowing Brenden Steen to recover somewhat? was that what prevented him from getting the three count? Going to the well too many times, signaling the cutthroat, this might be the end. Got both of those arms locked. Brenden Steen's wingspan, just too big, there's the Russian leg sweep. There it is from the professional. There it is. And we know what he's looking for now. With reckless abandon, north of 260 pounds, goes to the top. Wait a minute, Enzigiri. Enzigiri from Johnathan Vega. Oh, and just shoving him off, being draped over the top rope, and that is solid steel in those ropes. And here it is. Do you want to fly? Headbutt. Cover. 1, 2, 3. The professional racks up another dubby. Great victory from Brenden Steen against Johnathan Vega. It's good to have him back. But now to get her insight on her victory last week on The Reality of Wrestling, and also her opinion on the upcoming main event for the Diamonds title, let's take it back to the Queen of House Rose, Rachel Rose.
Ladies and gentlemen, Haley backstage here with the Queen of House Rose, Rachel Rose. I wanted to congratulate you on your match that you had last week.
On my win that I got last week, which honestly isn't surprising. And honestly, I should be congratulated every time I walk in this building for my impeccable win-loss record. Do you pay attention to that? No, actually, you probably don't. You're too busy dyeing your hair. But if you haven't looked, my win-loss record blows every other diamond out of the water. The only time I lose around here is when a ref forgets how to do their job. But that's okay. In the main event tonight, it's not me, unfortunately. It's AQA, Big Return, versus our champion, Promise Braxton. But that's okay. I'll be back here watching it real close. And whoever wins, congratulations. You'll be bending the knee.
Well, guys, that sucked. I think they cheated. I'm not quite sure, but I can't do it alone anymore. I'm gonna need... Hey, what? Izzy, who did this? Izzy!
Legion! Hey, Legion, do we have your attention now?
Do we? Shawn Hendrix, Ozzy James, Izzy all right? Check on your boy. See, that's what happens when you stand in the way of the renegades. They want us to pay our dues. They want us to stand in line and wait. We ain't doing none of that around here. Legion, you're just an example of our statement. You think you're evil? Let's see how evil you could really get.
For over 13 years, the King of Solar Screens has been an industry leader, and we proudly use 100% American-made products. Home of the $55 any size, any color solar screen.
Well, what about arches?
$55.
What about circle?
$55.
What about rectangles?
$55.
Any size, any color, install free.
The King of Solar Screens, on time, every time.
Now can you dig that, sucker?
Well, it is time for our main event, Booker T. Diamonds Championship on the line. And coming back into the World Gym Arena for the first time in nearly a year, AQ QA challenges for that championship that she lost so many months ago.
Yes, exactly, Brad. We all know now the method to all the madness, AQA, is moving uptown, kind of like the Jeffersons, you know what I mean? to New York high-rise apartment, high up in the sky, you know. This is AQA's last match at Reality of Wrestling, but let's just say this. I don't think it's going to be the last time we see AQA inside the squared circle at the Reality of Wrestling.
She's got a big challenge ahead of her this evening, dedicating this match in memory of retired U.S. Marine, the Honorable Tim Person of Melvin, Alabama, her pastor, who was unfortunately killed recently. She's dedicating this match in his honor. We're going to see if she can get the job done and win the Diamonds Championship in her final appearance. You know, Book, a long time we've seen Promise here at Reality of Wrestling, now a little bit north of a year she's been competing for us, and I would always say, will she live up to her name? She has a lot of promise, but will she live up to that? And she has done that tenfold. She has now captured that Diamonds Championship, ending the streak, ending the reign of the longest-serving Diamonds Champion in history, Roxy. Big, big stuff already happening in 2021 for Promise Braxton.
The thing is, Brad, I can tell you from experience, you know, winning a championship is one thing. Going out there and defending the championship, especially against someone like Angela, AQA, it's going to be a tough, tough task.
Isaac Bouillon holds the title up high. Here we go in our main event this week, AQA's last dance, if you will. Can she get the job done? Man, that would be some story, Booker T. You first saw AQA many years ago when she came to your fantasy camp, and then she has now exploded onto the scene. She holds that unique distinction of being the most viewed competitor in Reality of Wrestling history. One of her matches north of 30 million views. Incredible.
You know, the thing is, man, it seems like, man, just time, man, time's passed so, so fast. It seems just like yesterday when AQA walked in the Reality of Wrestling and said, I want to sign up. You know, she looked like my daughter. I was like, what are you doing here? And now, you know, turn the page. You know, 4 years later, she's now signed to a contract in a major company. You got to love that right there. It's all to her testament and will and hard work that she put in to this game. And I look at her right here. Beautiful armbar right there. Beautiful armbar extension right there. Promise is in a lot of trouble because she's going against a number one contender.
Ironic you bring up that word trouble, which was once a moniker of Ember Moon there at WWE, another one of your students who passed through this Reality of Wrestling dojo, if you will. Have to see if the same championship accomplishments will fall on Angela, but look at Promise Braxton getting right back in this thing, Booker T, having great wrist control for AQA. Oh, great reversal.
You know, one thing I always talk to, you know, young students like Promise, you know, watch the good ones. And I'm sure she's watched every move AQA has pulled off inside the square circle. She wants to know, what does it take to get upwards to 30 million views on one of her matches as well, Bradley?
Absolutely, Booker T, and she's well on her way, having so much success early on in her career. Look at that from AQA. Look at that. Beautiful pinning attempt. Cover one, two, reversal one, and a kick out after one.
That's what I'm talking about right there, Brad. That's what I'm talking about. You could tell Promise is ready for this contest right here. This is not something she's thinking about going out here and slipping on a banana peel or anything. You always got to study the opponent and study. I'm talking about on a regular basis.
Absolutely.
Beautiful.
Angela making sure she's utilizing that count. You got to wonder if ring rust will be a play. Big chop to the chest there.
I mean, you can tell right now these young ladies have been watching each other.
and promised that anytime she see an opening, she's going to try to take it. But right there, AQA is like Johnny on the spot. Oh, beautiful.
Wow, look at that. And AQA uncharacteristically talking a little smack, talking a little trash to Promise Braxton. She looked like Tom Brady at the Super Bowl. There we go, though. Nice duck there from Promise Braxton.
Beautiful, beautiful there. Look at the timing on that. Look at that deep inside crescent arm drag right there. Shades of one of the great ones, Ricky the Dragon, Steamboat. I could never do that arm drag like that. I always wanted to, just never could pull it off.
Sure looks pretty. And now she got her side headlock right there on the ground. AQA controlling the offense and really the pace of this match.
Promise Braxton shot to the rib, though. There again, a window just opened, just cracked open for a second, and Promise was just slipped right in there.
You know, you said, Booker T, it's one thing to win, it's another to defend. You do have to wonder if
Look at that. Beautiful action right there. Beautiful, not to cut you off, Brad, but beautiful action. Beautiful drop kick there by AQA. AQA is back, and she's looking to take the championship back and put it around her waist and claim the throne all over again.
Cover one and a kick out. Slow to get to that cover was AQA. I think she knew it. You saw with her gesture right there. But what I was going to say, Book, is you almost wonder, is it too much too soon for Promise Braxton? Has she had too much success too early on? Is she going to go the way of a Paige Van Zandt or something that way?
You know, I'm sure people, you know, ask the question to Muhammad Ali, you know, was he too young to be the world heavyweight champion? I think that's when it's beautiful, beautiful drop kick there.
Look at that.
Promise. I think that's when it's time to seize the moment when you're young, like a Promise Braxton.
One,
here we go.
Two. Talk about seizing the moment. Promise Braxton zeroing in on a great injury right there, or a great opportunity from injury, I should say.
Look at the forms. It's just the way we teach down the reality of wrestling. Don't rush it. Just lay those spots in real nice and snug. That's reality of wrestling style.
Oh! Chop to the chest again from Promise Braxton. And now what is she doing here? Karen AQA into the corner and now in a tree of woe.
You know what I like about what Promise is doing right now? There's nothing soft about what Promise Braxton is doing right here. She's not, you know, thinking like this is a cakewalker. She's making sure she's taking care of business, and she's stepping on some toes and keeping on walking, Jack. Here we go.
Oh, that core strength really came to AQA's benefit, but Braxton still had it scouted. Incredible. Incredible form from the champion right now. Battling through adversity, cover one, two, and a kick out from AQA.
Bullion, you know, might have been a little bit slow on the count right there.
You saw Promise Braxton just grabbing at the hair, now stomping down.
Beautiful. And the thing is, Promise is not rushing it right now. She's making sure she's taking her time. You know, she's measuring every shot. Just like that shot right there to the lower base of the spine. That's almost a debilitating shot.
Back elbow right there into the middle turnbuckle. And look at that.
Beautiful.
Step through, reverse neck breaker.
Beautiful.
Cover. One, two.
Get in that bullion. This is a contest right here, Brad. This is what I'm talking about. You know, we heard The Undertaker talking a few weeks back about, you know, wrestlers being soft. And I look at the ladies here in reality of wrestling. It's nothing soft about the ladies, the diamonds. The diamonds, they got a rough edge in reality of wrestling. And I'm telling you right now, the guys, the men will step up to the plate just as well, guys. It's reality of wrestling. If you want to get some, guys, go to realityofwrestling.com.
Always appreciate a plug there. Diamonds are the hardest surface, right? The hardest element known to man. As AQA, someone who's been definitely tough in her career, tries to battle back. And I wonder, Booker, is the sentimentality of the moment getting to AQA? Everyone wants to be Peyton Manning and walk off with a Super Bowl, or be Kobe Bryant and in his last game drop 60. Angela, oh wait, look at that cover. One.
Beautiful inside cradle.
Beautiful there. But is AQA allowing this moment, the sentimentality of the moment, to get to her backslide?
Cover
one.
Backslide right here. I don't think so. I think Promise Braxton is just stepping up to the moment right here. You say 1 year in, Promise Braxton right there is working like a seasoned veteran.
Look at that. Look at that. Draping the neck of the reality, former reality of wrestling champion along that bottom rope. That is steel cable inside those ropes.
Let me tell you something, Brad. We're going to have to post this match. We're going to have to get this match on Twitter. We're going to have to get this match on Instagram. We're going to have to let the world see what reality of wrestling is all about.
Two. Another kick out from the former champion, AQA.
Promise Braxton doing something right there I don't like. That's sitting on her behind after a cover. You got to get to your feet. You got to be thinking one, two, sometimes three steps ahead. And right now, it seemed like that one moment could have opened a door for AQA, but no.
Close, but no cigars, the saying goes. And AQA, you see it all over her face, feeling the effects from the offense of the force of Promise Braxton.
Combination, beautiful combination, three-punch combination by Braxton right there. And no pop of the leg. It was beautiful.
Up to the second rope here. AQA sitting on the top turnbuckle.
Oh, going for that giant superplex off the top rope. But no, AQA blocks it.
Oh, look at that. Just shoved her off the second rope.
The thing is, AQA is in a comfort zone on that top rope. We know that.
We know that. Always looking to wield that shooting star press. But what is this? Swinging DDT. Perfection. Perfection. Can she capitalize, Booker T?
Got a cover right now. She's been taking a beating from Promise Braxton right now. Promise still has a lot of fuel left in the tank. I don't know how to call this thing right now, Brad. It could go either way.
Yeah, it seems like as the pendulum swings one way, then it swings the other.
The fight. There's a fight. There's a fight right here. I wouldn't call this a cat fight either. This is a back alley brawl.
Oh, look at that. Right hands now being blocked.
Oh, look at the double block. Woo. That beautiful, beautiful work right there.
Promise Braxton able to get some waist control. AQA shoots her off. Oh, look at that. A big super women punch cover. And a kick out. A kick out from Promise Braxton, the champion. AQA thought she added one with a knockout punch. Beautifully done.
I can tell you right now, I'm going to miss AQA, but I'm so proud of her making it to the next level. I got chills just saying that right there. But right now, we definitely got a hell of a replacement in Promise Braxton.
Going for that enziguri. Oh, look at that.
Beautiful.
Heel kick to the back, cover.
Caught on the rebound right there.
One, two, and a kick out again from AQA. Incredible. I can't believe what I am seeing. This is your main event at the flagship of Texas Wrestling, the reality of wrestling. And what a main event it's been thus far, Booker T.
Yes, like I say, man, AQA Promise Braxton is stepping up to the plate. And there again, Bradley, what a main event it is.
Cover, double hook, one, two, and a kick out at the last possible moment from Promise Braxton. That bookend normally puts him away.
Well, you know, normally when I do it, that bookend normally, you know, gets the three count, take you to the pay window. But there again, the just not knowing the proper execution, perhaps. Maybe that was it.
Now, Angela. Hey,
she's getting frustrated.
She's getting very frustrated.
This is not the AQA I normally know. She's normally poised, you know, like a Freddie Couples over a putt.
Oh, look at that. A stop to the middle of the sternum. And now she has her lined up for Booker T. That highlight reel shooting star press we've seen her do oh so many times. She's climbing up to the top.
In position.
AQA.
In position to land it. Oh, wait a minute. I thought I saw a Promise Braxton still got a lot of movement left.
Up on the shoulders. Oh, and look at that.
Wow.
Dropping it with a... almost a modified GTS. Back up on the shoulders again. Oh, and look at that.
Wow. That's it.
Cover. One, two, three.
Wow. That tells me something right there, Brad. That doesn't tell me, that AQA is taking a step back or anything. like that, that tells me Promise Braxton, since capturing the championship, she has that, what I call that cloak of invincibility, and it took her to a victory tonight over AQA. You gotta love it.
Incredible. You have to give it up for the current champion, Promise Braxton, or Booker T. As incredible as that defense was, we now have to turn our attention to the story inside the squared circle. AQA catches an L. She is defeated in her final stand here at the Reality of Wrestling. You know she wanted to go out holding that championship right there. But we have to give Promise Braxton the credit she deserves. She beat one of the very best we've ever had, and this Diamonds division has been built on the name AQA.
But it goes to show you, in Reality of Wrestling, you know, even when you're the best, you still got to go out there and put the work in. That's what AQA is all about. Beautiful, beautiful job.
And a kiss goodbye to the Reality of Wrestling faithful. Thank you, AQA. Forward executive producer Booker T. And Charmel Huffman. Forward director Kevin Bernhardt. My name is Brad Gilmore. We will see you next week on the Reality of Wrestling.